Antiwa. That is the name of what we're going to see here today, folks. Welcome everyone who's going to be watching via the VOD, or YouTube, or live here right now on Twitch. I'm your host, Joffrey1195, and today is the match Andromeda Androxus and Medic Vasil versus Lyama, and of course, Deathstroke. Now, Deathstroke, he is a very good player. Lyama, she can do some good, but I think their strength is in being in with good teammates. But right now, here's the score, folks. This is the match for today. We are in the section 2. Yeah, okay. So if they win, they're going to be facing off Grosser versus Square. That's going to be pretty heavy. Well. Page up, because right now, if I switch back to the game screen, we are about to set up the match. Everyone is here and present. Everyone seems to have a stable ping. Medic Vasil having the highest ping right now, 120 ping. That may affect his performance just a tiny bit. And Droxus, 8 ping, that's very good. Deathstroke, 60. And Lyama, 89. Representing the Jaeger team, Deathstroke actually fighting his own clan members here today. That's pretty interesting. It would be pretty interesting to fight your own clan members. But Lyama is on her own, representing the Alliance team here today. There you go. Tunis Harbor will now be loaded. It looks like that is the map they have decided to play here today, folks. So I'm looking forward to some good action, good strategies. Hopefully we're going to see that. In the meantime, I'm going to quickly pop back the scoreboard so you can see again what's going on. The matches are progressing, so yeah, we're around halfway through. This is not the moment to screw up. They really have to give it all they got. Loading Tunis Harbor. Thanks again, everyone who's watching right now via the YouTube and the live stream. Tunis Harbor, please load, man. Yeah, hopefully we're going to see some good action here. Now, of course, being the unimprovised mess that I am, everything has been set up only 30 minutes ago. So, excuse me if I'm checking my second screen here from time to time. But yeah, the round has been called live. Looks like it. Command live has been given. I'm just gonna wait. Set the next map as Camp Gibraltar. So Tunis Harbor and Camp Gibraltar, that's going to be an interesting mix. Here goes the Jaeger team. So it looks like they're just testing right now. And they're gonna reset the map. Yeah, they're gonna switch it back to Kemchi. Alright. They probably wanna do Tuna Sabo next. Alright, who do I see in the stream? I see Millwall. Welcome, dude. It was a real shame that you could not talk with me here today. I would have loved that. Maybe next time, I'm pretty sure we would have made a really good commentary duo. But unfortunately, I'm going to have to come up myself. Even though I would have loved to have you by my side here today. Because I think today we're going to have a pretty interesting match. Like I said, Deathstroke is a pretty good guy in my opinion. Now keep in mind that it is anti-Ewa. So it is everyone who has a KD of below 1.7. So yeah, it is not really the best of players, but still, even if you have a bad KD, I mean, bad, quote to say, in the tournament standards, even if you have a KD that's like that, you can be pretty good. Deathstroke, I think, yeah, he's pretty good. Now, the Jaeger team, they have the advantage of being together as a clan, and they already know how each other plays. So hopefully, we'll see some interesting strategies. It does look like Medic War is the squad leader. But we're gonna go back to this perspective. I'm quickly gonna pop back the EU. See where they are. They're still getting actually eliminated by Andro Zeus. They're gonna make the ready command. Yeah, it was just a warm up. It's gonna be interesting to see the strategies they're gonna use. Usually people just run, just rush about one by one, side by side, but of course the flanks are going to be the most important thing. If they split up, that can be good in situations, but not in all situations. They have to control their flanks, make sure that they get the numerical advantage, that they outnumber the enemy by catching one guy off guard, and that could be very great for them. Now, today, it's kind of special because I'm the only streamer, so unfortunately Kringo Mango is not streaming, so there's not going to be a Russian version of this stream. There's just going to be me all alone and the players running the commands themselves. It's pretty special, but it should go marvelous. Still, nades have been thrown. That's one nade. Second nade has been thrown. Ooh, that's a lot of nades being thrown. Now keep in mind, guys, they only have basic unlocks, and they only have two nades per soldier. Deathstroke shooting some nice accuracy. Ooh, that nade landed very close, but he's just gonna content himself to suppressing the enemy. And he's gonna retreat back to his teammate, who's gonna be caught up with them too. He's outnumbered, so that could be very bad for him. Medic Vasil is slowly creeping forward, but fortunately got eliminated by Deathstroke, who was quick to react, and Liama taking out the Androxus, who was out of cover. He was surprised by the situation. He did not expect Deathstroke to suddenly strike and kill Medic Vasil. That was unfortunate. I don't think they really had that planned. There was some bad cover usage, to say the least. Oh, Deathstroke using some nice accuracy with the Krylov. Getting revived. They're gonna secure those flanks. Throwing some nades. One nade has been thrown, completely misses. Second nade has been thrown, also aiming for the middle, but unfortunately no one was there. Deathstroke missing a few of his shots. They're gonna get the flank going on. Exactly. Nice flanking action. Wow, Deathstroke really nice doing the flank. I saw that coming, but of course it is easy to say that you saw it coming when you're in spectator mode. I think these guys on the ground did not really expect that. But that was a nice flank by Deathstroke. 6-0 for Deathstroke. That's really good. We will see how they do, but right now they need to focus. They're gonna throw some nades in the middle again. They're not gonna really throw nades at the sides. They're gonna spot the enemy. Liama, Gamma killing Androxus because Androxus was outnumbered and out of cover. There was two fatal penalties. Right now, the strategies they're doing, it's not really paying off. They need to maybe throw some nades more on the sides, not the middle, because it doesn't look like the Jaeger team is actually sticking to the middle. They're just camping the sides. That nade would have been good if it landed close, but those two nades did not land close. That was four nades thrown, all the nades being thrown. Medic Vasil being a good medic. And Dox is getting sniped by Deathstroke. Deathstroke again, wow. Oh, Medic War wasn't the back of that. He was already being aimed at. That was very bad timing for Medic Vasil getting absolutely obliterated by Deathstroke. Right now, Deathstroke being 11-0. Deathstroke is not giving them any chance right now. They need some solid strategies if they want to overcome Deathstroke, which I feel like is going to carry this team here today. Liama is just going to stroll along, and Deathstroke, it looks like he's going to be the main guy of this round. If they can't take down Deathstroke, they may have a chance at taking the flag. Nades being thrown, that's one nade. That is... that's not even a second nade. Trying to spot them. Yama being very good on the accuracy. The flank by Androxus. He has not spotted him. Deathstroke, Androxus is waiting on his... Yeah, he's a squad leader, so he's waiting on Medic Vasil to spawn back on him. So he can get the good flank going. That excellent, excellent. Oh, narrowly missing Deathstroke. That was bad. They should have killed him. They really needed to kill him. Nades have been thrown. Shotgun is being pulled out. Oh no, Androxus is getting killed. But Liama getting flanked. Medic Vasil also flanking Deathstroke. Excellent. Wow, they're going to cap this flag. And hopefully now they're not going to be contested. We will see. Can they spawn back? No, they did not spawn back in time. They got this flag secured, folks. Wow, excellent. They managed to cap the first flag. Now, we're probably around 2 minutes. Around 4 minutes into the first match. So they may still have a chance to equalize this if they play smart. Nades have been thrown. None of them hitting. Excellent. Deathstroke getting surprised from the high point. Liama getting flanked by two sides from the high point, and Medic Vasil is not gonna... I think Medic Vasil is gonna hang back. That is very bad. He shoots shots forward, and Droxus right now could really need his help. I do not know what they're doing, but this is bad. They cannot split up like this. Androx is getting killed alone because he has no one watching his flank. That is why Medic Vasil needed to actually help him. Now Medic Vasil finds himself all alone, and that is not good. Ooh, there is a lot of lag. I apologize if you can feel that on the stream, but that is a lot of lag. Looks like it's over though. Alright, Medic Vasil trying to spot them, trying to do some preventive spotting. But he really needs to charge up. Now, he's not going to do much here. And as long as he doesn't move up, they don't have the manpower to be able to charge up to the second flag. I'm going to quickly switch back to the EU team, see what they're up to. It looks like Liama and Deathstroke are going to be defending because they actually expect the Jaeger team to charge up, but right now they're not charging up, and so it's an odd stalemate because these guys know that these guys should charge forward, but these guys are not doing what they're supposed to do. And Goxus, you need to move up. Medic Vasil, you need to move up. They're just expecting them to go up the stairs, but they're not really doing anything. And Medic Vasir is just hanging back. Medic Vasir, you need to move up. You need to actually support and Androxus. Ooh, that was nice. Getting Liama, that was other physician. He spotted him. Now Androxus is going to be all alone unless Medic War charges up again. There was a nade. Nade hitting very close. Damn it. Medic Vasil finally charging in. Finally. He's gonna wait on his teammate. He's the squad leader after all. And hopefully they hope to get a nice flank. Now the EU team might hope to charge back up. He's gonna get spotted. Excellent, Yama going down by Medic Vasil, excellent kill. They have the numerical advantage, they're gonna probably press forward. Granada. Granada. Throwing both his nades, hitting nothing. They're currently unaware of any of the positions. Let's look at where they are. They're defending the top right now. Deathstroke is on top. Liama is on the bottom. She's going up right now to the second floor. They've been definitely spotted. Sorry, man. Droxus is gonna... looks like he's gonna try again the stairs, even though Deathstroke is defending those very steps he's trying to climb up, along with Liama trying to shoot him. And he's quickly gonna get shot up. Medic Vasil is not... he's not doing the proper strategies. Medic Vasil, you need to be up with your squad leader. Well, not just your squad leader, but you need to help your teammate. He's not gonna be able to get this thing alone. You need someone to watch your flank or your back if you're gonna do tournaments 2x2. It's just sad. It looks like, yeah, they lost. The Jaeger team lost this one purely and simply because they were not able to charge in. And yes, McCaffeine, bonjour, my friend. Good to see you. So I think that is 1 point for Deathstroke and Liama. Easily taking this purely and simply because Medic Vasil was not with his teammate, did not actually support Androxus that was charging forward. And that it was a very big mistake. And you really do not want to do that. Medic Vasil then again having a 130 ping right now. That could really impact this ping. So yeah, everyone who's watching right now, welcome everyone. I appreciate each and every single viewer. If you want to see more, of course, of the tournament, because I will be hosting everything live here on Twitch, then feel free to consider following. I will do my best to cover the entire event. Now, speaking of events, right now, Jaeger has been swept sides. They're going to defend this point. And we will see if they can mount an effective defense. Droxus getting targeted by nades. And Phylofar getting actually killed by Yama. Excellent shooting. Now he's going to be outnumbered. Medic Vasil is going to take cover. But he got shot by two people at once, and there goes the first flag. They need to respawn right now. Contested flag. Androxus respawned on time. He's gonna throw some nades, which are gonna land very close, but too far away. That was both his nades. They lost the flag. That was very bad. Androxus is charging head in without even seeing him. He's gonna try for the revive. Medic Vasil, oh my god. Medic Vasil managing to kill one guy, but he could not get the second guy. That is the first flag already down. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the first flag already down. Now they're gonna use the advantage that they got and charge forward, but right now it looks like they're gonna instead choose to defend, which is gonna be an interesting strategy. They're gonna defend against the Jaeger team. They're not choosing to rush forward right now. They're gonna just defend.
forces in sight.
And if they play it right, they could use the numerical advantage once they kill them to actually get forward. I think they spotted each other. I definitely do think they spotted each other. Your French is, I guess I can understand it, but McCaffrey, your French is not very clear, to say the least. You know you can speak English to me, but your French was not very understandable. Anyway, Medic Vasil's gonna take the high ground. Actually, stay there, stay put. He's gonna retreat, not spotting him. And Droxus is gonna... charging, I think you heard that. I think he heard those nades being thrown. He's gonna prepare to go around the... I think he's gonna wait for them to charge forward. Oh, but he got surprised by himself. Medic Vasil now is panicking. He has to go around the side and kill him before he reaches the end. He was not able to kill him. That's two people going into the perimeter of the flag. They have no idea where they are. They're gonna surround them completely. Nice shotgun action. Excellent. And Droxus getting a kill. His first kill in this round. Liama actually doing very good right now. She has 6 kills and had 0 deaths before dying once. So that is pretty damn impressive. And Fox has been completely surprised. He had his map pack out. He was totally not anticipating that. And right now they're gonna have the Jaeger team is gonna have the numerical advantage. They're gonna charge in right into the center. Medic Vasil right now is trying to look for them. And Droxus respawn in a bad position. He's gonna get quickly flanked by two people. Millwall, who has the worst defense, you ask? okay. Jaeger offensive in World War II, you dick. Jaeger offensive in World War II. Well, right now that will be Jaeger, my friend. Hey, Minimal Kaminsky. Good to see you, dude. By the way, if you follow, you have your name pop up on the screen right now if you do that. So, yeah, if you're not gonna have cool little notifications, it's good to see. But yeah, it's good to see everyone watching. We will have an interesting match going on today. I'm happy to be able to be your host here today, and I hope you appreciate what I do. And Drox is gonna have a little face-off against Liama, but they're not really able to shoot each other. Medic Vasil, what are you doing?
We got Brett spotted.
Medic Vasil not being on point where he was supposed to be. And that left Androxus being completely killed by himself. Medic Vasil again is the squad leader, so if he stays back, there's always good, but he stays back way too much, in my opinion. He should not stay back like that. It has caused their team more trouble than anything. I think if they would have switched the squad leader position between each other, that would have been a good decision, because right now I do not think Medic Vasil is being a good squad leader by hanging back so much and not, you know, being with his with Androxus. He's not really supporting him. Always do, mate, even more when you're playing on your own, mate, but you're not playing so often anymore. Yeah, I'm not playing so often anymore. It's quite a shame. I mean, I'm really quite busy, but yeah. Be right back. Sorry about that, I had family coming in. Anyway, yeah, I'm not playing so often anymore for the simple reason that I have a job right now. And I'm kind of tired when I come home and stuff, so you know. Sorry about that. Family sometimes can just barge into your room. Oh, Alliance Goetz has been going in. Of course, now I lost track of that because of family. Medic Vest, you're getting killed by Liama. I think they... Yeah, Liama is gonna use the high ground to just kill them. Hopefully both. Wow, Liama right now. Come on, Liama. Getting all these kills. That is a slaughter. Liama, 13 kills. And now they're gonna rush to the flag. Then they'll probably cap it. If they cannot contest it by spawning back, they're gonna be able to cap this. And Drax is doing really badly right now. Two kills to 8 deaths because he was not supported by Medic Vasil. He was not supported by his teammate. And that is very much a shame. The second map, I believe, is Tunis Harbor, if you're asking, Miro. Oh, that synchronized fire that I was gonna bring back is gonna bring down Liama and Deathstroke. So thank God they're gonna secure this flag. Get a little bit of time to breathe. Why is it a 2v2 only? Because 2v2, well, of course, it is not the only event that Nov Games host. For example, there's a 5v5, there's even a Titan match, as I was told. But, and also Gunship, also, I think. But 2v2 is interesting on its own because they have, you know, they have basic unlocks. They cannot just sprint around, do everything they can. They cannot just ramble their shit. They have to use some strategies. Covering your teammates is really important. In this type of games, you really see who's being a good teammate and who has good aim. And I think is really good to see. And it's really interesting to see the decisions that people take, because keep in mind, these people are communicating with each other in real time right now. They're fighting for a championship, so it's interesting to see what decisions they do, and we can analyze these right here on the stream, on live on Twitch, and I love doing that. So of course, if you love watching it, then of course give it a big old follow. I will appreciate that. But the shameless self-promotion aside, yeah, it is pretty damn interesting now. And Drox is gonna charge ahead again. Medic Vasya is gonna be bad. He's not gonna actually follow up, which is gonna get Androxus killed on his own. You see what I mean? They're not working together. You see what I mean, Minimal Kaminsky? They're not working together, so one gets killed. And it's stuff like this to analyze that's really cool. We've had matches where there was an intense back and forth, like, as soon as one guy died, it was immediately one side again. They kept the flag, they immediately got pushed back, you know, and stuff like that. And, there's matches like these where you got bad team play, and there's other matches where you had, I think yesterday, you had 18 kills to 0 deaths. I don't actually remember who it was right now, but yeah. Yeah, I do feel like Pac is giving you a chance right now. Ooh, I think that was pretty much a headshot. Jaeger team is not, you know, for being clan members, they're not really walking out together, and right now they lost again. It is bad. Androxus, why it's bad, Minimal Kamsky, is because Androxus gets himself killed. But keep in mind, the tickets, they count. They have 100 tickets, and they have 4 matches, so 400 tickets in total across each match. Each match they get a point based on the number of tickets. If it is a draw at the end, it will be counted on all the tickets they lost in the total. But yeah, Androx is getting himself killed all alone because he has no teammate support, and so they're just losing tickets, and that's what's getting them killed. If they just work together, I feel like they could probably push back the pack team. But like, then again, they just need to kill Deathstroke, because I feel like Deathstroke is carrying this match. Yeah, they need to change strategy to get a flag back. Exactly, that is exactly it. And by the way, that was my bad. The next map is not going to be Tunis Harbor, it's going to be Fall of Berlin. Fall of Berlin in itself is very interesting because you have 4 ways to go around. You have this way, which a defender will usually put themselves here to see who's going above. You have this way on top, and you have this main way, but something we rarely see people do is use this way across the side. But then again, a well-placed infantry guy could cover the second flank. If I just put myself here. A well-placed guy could cover all these angles. Of course, they need to spot all the time. to try to get them because they don't have commanders or stuff like that. It is purely relying on skill and teamwork. And keep in mind, this is only anti-EVA. There's been some amazing matches that are on EVA, and these are to come. And these can also be seen on my YouTube playlist or on Twitch. Preferably my YouTube right now, because Twitch is being a little bit of an ass with the uploads. For some reason, the videos are being privated, and I cannot, for the life of me, get them to be public, so I cannot actually, get people to see them, but they're there, so yeah, I'm just gonna upload them to YouTube, because on YouTube I don't have any problems. But yeah, Androxus is gonna be with Medic Vasil on top right now. Gonna get spotted by Deathstalk, easily killing them. Wow, getting pistoled in the head. They just ran like headless chickens into him. I don't think they really expected him to be a defender there. Even though it is literally the same spot that the defender would always be to cover that flank. But for some reason they just charged down. They did not even fire a shot. They just, ran down like headless chickens. So yeah. Minimal Kamsky, though, I haven't seen you in a while, dude. What's up, dude? Like, where have you been, dude? Yeah, Deathstalk is an amazing player. Ooh, nades have been thrown, landing very close, but unfortunately not hitting anything. And Drox is gonna try to suppress them. Where is Medic Vasil? Medic Vasil just spawned. This is an excellent nade! Excellent killing, and Androxus. Jesus. 3J. Millwall, come on. But yeah, Minimal Kamsky. Seen you on Twitch, like, because I've been streaming a lot the event lately. Since starting September, I've been streaming pretty much every week and every day. The tournament, so I've been wondering where you've been, dude. You've been a good viewer. Oh, those nades are gonna probably damage him a little bit, but not enough. He's gonna pull the shotgun out, but he did not have enough reflexes. Fortunately, Medic Vasil gets some quick shots down, but his teammate's gonna be there to avenge him. He misses his defense. Oh, they're training right now, but they don't have the numerical advantage. And he got killed easily. Yeah. But yeah, I've been thinking of streaming a lot, some games. Like right now, there's a cards game, the Battleforge, that was shut down by EA in 2013 that has been brought back. But right now, it's kind of buggy because it's a developer team that's freelancing on it. So it's a lot of crashes. And it's very difficult to actually get in a match, but I wanted to stream that. Other than that, 2042, I don't really feel like it right now. I prefer to kind of watch right now. I love to actually comment what people are doing. I feel much more comfortable doing that. And also, when you stream, when you play, you also lose some frames, I've noticed. It creates a tiny bit of lag, but it's noticeable when you're shooting. And yes, I did play a lot of other games, but most of the games that I play, if I even play anything this past month, because I really have not been playing anything, it's just in private, because I don't want to have the stress of being live, controlling if everything's going on, because right lately I've been some problems with my internet connection, just been fucking me in the ass, so I don't know what's up with that. I'm still trying to figure it out. It just seems to randomly disconnect, and it's super frustrating, and I really don't want to have to deal with that. You want to see me in a gunship? Well, I might do that. It depends on... Because I will admit, I'm far from being the best gunshipper. So, when there's other people, kind of ruins the fun because you're always getting killed. So I try to play when, it's kind of even. Or when I can be a gunner, that is also cool. Anyway, let's go back to the match for a second. And Drox is gonna get some little pot shots on Liama, but Liama is in like some excellent cover right now. She's not gonna budge from there. And Drox is gonna use one of his two nades. The second nade has been thrown, trying to clear away. blowing up the container, doing no damage. Melee Gracial spawn Mac and his squad leader. Damn, and Melee Gracial getting absolutely destroyed by Liam on the side. Seems like they forgot about her, and of course they don't have any PK rockets, because that is not basic unlocks, and then also it's kind of not really skillful to just shoot PK rockets. At least in this type of competition, it has its uses, clearing out people, but in a competition like this, it has no place. Right now, they're kind of pinned. If they don't watch out, they're going to get flanked. They do not want to get flanked. They're going to throw some more nades, but suppress them, but the shotgun brings down and Droxes. And fortunately, the nade also kills Liama. Both going to revive each other. Going to be a little 1 second later. Pulling out the pistol, but it wasn't enough. Destro going down, and Liama also going down. They're going to cap this flag right away. They're not going to waste any time. And it looks like they've been kicked out of the flag. They're not going to be able to contest this. Wow. After all this fighting, they finally managed to get a flag. Well, you know, some people lose, but, you know, they have some honor in that because they fought like hell. And we can really give them some merit, even if people lose. Sometimes it can be a loss just because of, you know, 10 tickets less, but that doesn't mean that they didn't fought like hell. So really, yeah, congrats. It's very interesting to see, actually, them using the high ground. They're really not feeling threatened because I don't think the Jaeger team right now has the best of accuracies. So they're not really feeling threatened by headshots. If it was against other players, they would probably duck down a lot more. But right now, they're really confident. Just taking out in the open. Again, Medic Vasil, what are you doing? He's actually getting sniped from all the way over there with the Krylov. Medic Vasil has been, in my opinion, the problems in these rounds because he's just been hanging back. And he's not actually been helping in boxes, really letting his teammate down. You know, that is not good. But yeah, I'm looking forward to minimal chemistry if when it's going to be a 5v5 or a Titan. I'm definitely looking forward to that. It's going to be later in the year if it happens. But yeah, before that, I was just a nobody on Nov Games, and you know, I'm kind of the first English streamer ever to be there. So it really is an honor and a privilege. And right now, yeah, it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool to be able to stream this. Yeah, Vasil is playing far too negative, says Millwall. He needs to man up. Exactly. Medic Vasil, again, hanging back. He could be on the flag right now. Though, if he can get his teammate to spawn back up. His teammate actually did not choose to spawn back on him. He's gonna go down from below, but he's gonna get spotted pretty much immediately. Drax is gonna throw some nades, landing pretty close, trying to suppress them. Oh, that could have been deadly. Fortunately, he got out of way just in time. Yeah, Khan was real good. I'm sad that there wasn't a round back then. Then again, back then I had a shitty internet connection that allowed me to only stream in 480, and it was very pixelated. If you actually go back in my streams, like, do I even have a highlight or a clip that contains shitty quality? I don't think I still do. But yeah, three years ago now, I streamed with 480p pixelated with a lot of pixels, and it was not really that great. So even if it was around back then in the Clan Wars, I don't think it really would have been great. Plus, I evolved a lot in the editor, as you can see right now by the banner I made myself. Game is pixels anyways, yes, that is true. Now, as you can see, that was interesting. Do you see the flag in the back? They're not able to cap this flag because they took this flag first. And that means that they cannot... there's a script in place that prevents people from just going back and taking the flanks from behind them. So that again is also good because it allows for no, you know, bullshit. It's really just no bullshit clan wars. Well, not clan wars, more like team wars tournaments. But you get what I mean. Deathstroke going down to a nade right now. He was the main defender, and actually that is the last flag. If they can defend this, I think that would be pretty interesting. Oh no! I think the break will be called because we just lost. We just lost Androxus. Oh no! They were at the last flag. Oh no! That is bad. What happened? They were at the last flag. They could have gotten a point and maybe came back from it. Looks like we're having some technical difficulties by Androxes who suddenly left, lost connection, or whatever happened. I hope nothing bad happened on his end. But we will probably call a break here. And the time was not up. If the time was up, it would just reset everything. Anyway, in the meantime, I'm gonna pop back the anti-Ewa scoreboard. And you can see your lovely live chat, which I love, by the way. And it's actually the first time I can really see it in action. So, yeah, I think I did some pretty good work with it. What do you guys think? I think it looks pretty good. It's not the best, of course, because, you know, I pretty much just improvise everything. But, yeah, that is the scoreboard right now. They're fighting to be against Grossa and Square. Grossa and Square have been doing really great if you've seen the previous live streams. But yeah, I'm kind of worried about I'm worried about Androxus right now. If he doesn't come back within 5 minutes, the match okay, a break. I'm quickly gonna pop back this, and of course this resets automatically. I don't want it to reset. There you go. So you can see break 2 minutes has been called. So if you're watching right now and you would like to eat something or eat something, do it right now. It's gonna be a 2:45 break. So if you're hungry or want something to drink, then please by all means get up, do it now because you have some time free. And Doxus just came back. Medic Vasil with the 200 ping, that is very nice. 200 ping. Oh yeah, sometimes it's not very stable, but yeah. But yeah, today is a very good day. It's really good to see you all on the stream. It's really good to be talking with people. Oh, that could have been amazing if they actually managed to defib each other. That could have been great. But yeah, I've been thinking about doing some more gameplay. So I'm probably gonna get back to that. It never even was made, not even with the EA servers. Yeah, yeah, that is very true. Who else do I see in the chat right now? I see a Skinny Seahorse, which I think is the first time I see him on this Twitch. So welcome, mate. I hope you're enjoying the stream. If there's anything you would like to say or something, then please let me know. And also, what do you guys think of me hosting this match today? How am I doing? I think I'm doing a good presentation of it. At least I'm trying. But the break has been completed. Ready command has been given. Androxus is ready. So I do not know what's going to happen with the match. It looks like they're going to cancel the match. That could be very interesting. If they cancel the match, that would mean that they have another try at the match. They still have around 2 matches left, 2 rounds left to actually come back. It is possible, but with the amount of tickets they lost in the first 2 rounds, it's gonna be quite challenging, to say the least. Thanks, mate. I really improved myself from the first match. If you actually go back from the very first live stream, it is not that good. Because I was still setting up stuff and, you know, I'm kind of a guy who improvises and goes along with it. And I just create stuff along the way. For example, the tournament screen and stuff like that, and live chat and stuff like that. It was, most of it was put around tournaments before the stream started. The previous ones I'm talking about. So yeah, it's all done at the last minute. Because usually I've been only notified at like 2 hours or 3 hours before the match even starts. So, you know, you're like, you know, today's gonna be a good evening, and all of a sudden, oh shit, there's a match. And also, oh shit, Medic Vasil got killed from behind by Lyama. Lyama, though, getting killed, pulling the shotgun out from Androxus, but it was not enough. He missed the shots on Deathstroke. Normally you only like me when I play with Jer. Yeah, that was a long time ago. Man, I'm going all the way back in January here. That is a long way back, but yeah. Jerry can be fun to comment with, but sometimes he can be obnoxious on some stuff. Very obsessed, to say the least. Like, always on politics. Like, when you're playing, people don't want to hear about politics. And he constantly, constantly talks about that. And he just doesn't get that, you know, it's a gaming this one, it's a gaming Twitch. And, you know, it has nothing to do there, so... You know, what can you do about it? But, you know, I'm not like him, so I do my own thing. Him and Jerry are ex-lovers. I wish I at least an ex. And Medic Vasya is gonna try to go toe-to-toe with the pistol. They're missing all their shots. Are they gonna go down to the knife? Oh, he tried to reload the shotgun, I think. And he got killed by the pistol by Deathstroke. Oh, wow. It's pretty even right now. The KD is pretty damn even. Actually, let's switch to pack. I've been on the wrong team this whole damn time. Oh yeah, they've been switched back again, yeah. Since the map got reset, it automatically switched them back. It's fucking bunny hopping. Well, keep in mind, the reduced spring is made so that they can not bunny hop that much. If you actually played for yourself on the tournament server, which I think you have, then you would see that there's really not a lot of strength to walk with. And personally, you know, it's a pain in the ass. I cannot live like that. Deathstroke killing Endvoxes. He had no reaction time in that. Absolutely got demolished. Now they're gonna charge forward, try to use the advantage they got. Minimal Kamsky, are you? Yeah, I think you already follow me, dude, if I remember. Because if you want, you can unfollow and refollow, because I did a new animation. I completely redid everything, and if you want to see that, then by all means do it. I think that'll be very cool. Just, you know, wait 1 minute before refollowing, I guess. So you can have your name pop up, and you kind of fits because you're making a comeback to the channel, so to say, to the stream at least. So, but I really do like it, and I think you will like it as well. And actually, it's the first time you'll probably ever hear a streamer tell people to unsubscribe, to unfollow. Anyway, Liama starting fourth, quickly killing Androxes. He was surprised. They're gonna quickly take this flag. Nice, Deathstroke. Finish him off, Androxes. They're not gonna be able to contest the flag anymore, at least I don't think so. Medic Vasil is incoming. Wow, they all missed all their shots. Medic Vasil getting some nice pistol. Following me for half a year. Wow, that is... You know what? I should get a loyalty thing going on. I think there's an app for that in the Streamlabs for the people who have been loyal for you a long time, or, you know, the longest watch time or something like that. Oh, there you go. Yeah, Millward did it. There you go. I think it was actually skewed to the side. Let me just check it real quick, folks. Just 1 second. Wow, okay, yeah, it was skewed to the side. Well, that was a fail. Okay, let me just transform that, stretch the screen, and there you go. Now it's fit the screen. So, Millwall, you could do that again if you wish. Great job, Hype, yeah. Yeah. Man! Medic Vasil and Vox is actually taking back the flag. I did not expect them to actually take back the flag, but it just goes to show you that sometimes stuff cannot be expected. And I think right now it's very even. I think they finally woken up from their sleep. The Jaeger team. I think they're finally getting into it right now. Ooh, that nade very, very close though. Gonna damage him a lot. Oh, that nade! Kappa emote. I haven't seen a Kappa emote in a long time, dude. That's like fucking vintage. Oh, wow! They actually went back around in the flag. I think, yeah, that was Androxus. He went back to the flag and capped it from behind. Wow, the Jaeger team might actually win this one. They might actually get a point. Though I would love to have the tickets and the time, but unfortunately there is a problem as there is a message that keeps popping up, you know, joining the battle if you just try to kill yourself. And it only goes away if you press A, but when you press A, you cannot move the camera. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. It's a spectator mode, so I can have free move. But unfortunately, that also means we are not going to have the tickets all the time, but we can estimate approximately. And I think Cream Go Mango is going to be really on time with the updating of the scores. I'm actually defending this right now. Very good. Let's see, let's switch back to pack. Let's see what I'm gonna do. Liam has, looks like he's gonna try to flank around. You beat these guys 2-2-1. 2-1. You should have entered yourself. Well, I mean, I don't really have any doubts in that, Millwall. You're pretty damn good. But, you know, if you say that and then you just get absolutely demolished, then it would be embarrassing, wouldn't it? Deathstroke in the air, I'm gonna secure this flag. They're gonna. And Rox has a medic version, is gonna spawn back in time and contest it. But Androxus was too late, and Benedict Vassil just got shot in the head. And that leaves us to the last flag, so I'm gonna retract my statement I said earlier. I do not think the Jaeger team will win, seeing the current rate of progressions of the flags. I think that will be a third point for Yama and Deathstroke. Spotting the enemies. Actually, well, actually killing them both there. They're gonna definitely sprint to the last flank, trying to secure the victory. If they can do a full cap, they will for sure have the 2 points. Millwall, you're just trying to get me to bring the Jade situation up, aren't you? Nades have been thrown, they're using all the nades, trying to dislodge them, but it's not gonna work out. Just gonna be not enough. They're gonna try to rush in, secure this flank. And Gox is getting killed by Deathstroke. Deathstroke getting killed by Medic Vassil. Liama is gonna shoot Medic Vassil. Oh, they're winning. But Liama is actually the squad leader right now. Oh, Deathstroke respawned back right in the squad leader. That could be very devastating. That could be the end. The explosion from the box kills himself. It kills him. That was very funny to see. But yeah, they're gonna take this flag, folks, and that's gonna be a full cap. Jesus Christ, that is 3 points to Liama and Deathstroke. Amazing to see. Now I think there's gonna be one last round left. Because, you know, they can still get a 4th point, but it doesn't really mean anything right now because they lost. But we will see if they will keep fighting for the honor. I think if they can give us a grand finish and still get a point, because right now they were so close to actually beating them back. Have you seen earlier? They came to the back and they actually sneaked around past them and captured the flag way in the back that forced them to go all the way back. If they keep doing that, you know, they could have a chance. And, you know, hopefully you can see that. That's gonna go to Tunis Harbor. But I think it is over. We'll see in just a second. Let me focus on the commands right now. But you know, these are the type of matches that I love, seeing unexpected stuff like the boxes blowing up. You know, that was very cool to see. And yes, Tunis is also a good map because you can swim, you can go various ways. It's very open, so it allows for a lot of precision firing. So let me see the commands. What are gonna do? Keep in mind that Androxus certainly left a match when they were about to win, and in my opinion, they deserve a second chance because they were about to win that last one. They were about to cap it, but then he crashed out. I'm just waiting on the comments right now, on the commands. See what they're gonna say. Yeah, Vasil's ping tonight is not very terrible. 140. It can do a number, but you know, you can still do good. But it certainly didn't help him. But even if, you know, if he can actually take the ping and compensate, I think he did pretty good. For what he was given, he was pretty good. It is perhaps also the reason why he chose to hang back. I think it is also perhaps the reason why he hanged back and not really helped Androxus. But still, that is not a reason to just, you know, not help your teammate because he got killed way too often. He penalized his team. And they just lost way too many tickets by simply not assisting each other. Right now, I'm wondering what is Deathstroke and Liama doing. What are they doing? Gonna quickly switch back to the scoreboard seeing if I'm not missing anything, and also you can see your lovely comments here, good to see. Yeah, I'm really wondering what they're up to. Anyhow, the Jäger team definitely lost that one. I kinda expected the Jäger team to hold up a bit more, but as you could see earlier, the unit cohesion within the squad really was, in my opinion, the thing that got them. If they had the cohesion going for most of the time, I think they could have held their own, but they did some pretty amazing move, like going from behind and stuff. But yeah, right now they're also confused. I think they might be talking in the Discord, but of course I do not speak Russian, so I have no idea what's going on right now. Let me quickly see. Yeah, they're all there together. And actually, Goetz is by himself. That's pretty interesting, considering he's a judge. No way, you know, he cannot be a judge because he's in the same clan as Liama is. They cannot be that the same clan to avoid bias. So yeah, if it is. Oh, what are we doing? Are we gonna restart the map? Are we gonna have a last match? Oh boy, are we gonna have a last match? And also, Millwall, I'm looking forward to having you next time talking with you. I think it's gonna be great. If you can make it, that'd be amazing. Because, you know, I can talk by myself, and it's amazing to talk with you guys, but I think if me and Millwall talk together on stream, I think that'd be pretty amazing. No, please come tournaments before so I can actually do sound tests, because I hate having to improvise as much as I have to improvise because of everything that happens. I actually prefer to have everything set up in advance so I don't have any stress. Because believe it or not, 15 minutes ago, before the match started an hour ago, I was notified that the server was down. No, that there was no server. 15 minutes before the match started, I was like, what the fuck? You know, what what is this? Yeah. I'm the one streaming here. I'm the one who's gonna get the blame if I do false events, you know? Yeah, it looks like I'm gonna end this. But yeah, I'm the one streaming, so, you know, as... you can compensate for my slight autism. Yeah, Yeah, I guess. I mean, you know, since you're English and I'm French, I think we might have another 100 years war going on. But yeah, I'm just gonna. Honestly, I think I'm just gonna call it here. Oh wait, Goris spawned back. Goris is back. If they wanna do another one, then it's up to them. But I do not want to have to stream for a long time because the more I stream, the more fucking gigabytes it's gonna take to upload this to YouTube. Please make a decision. Okay, let's put a timer. If within 1 minute I do not see any announcements or anything, we will call it here. Anyhow, Minimal Kansky, what do you think of the match that happened today in Millwall? What do you think? Do you have any comments on the actions that you saw today? I already said what I had to say earlier, but it is always good to have the opinions from the viewers. Unless you really have nothing else to add to it, you can do it now because it will be a VOD also now. Now the VOD, the thing is, when my internet connection randomly crashes and fucks me in the ass, then I have to put these in the editor, all right, and put these back together, stitch them back together, and also it means I can edit them. But the main thing is I have to stitch them back together and re-render them. And that is a lot of gigabytes to render. And also, you have to upload that. And sometimes it seems to crash mid-upload on Twitch. Okay. And when it uploads, it seems to only be private. Now, if it is just a live stream, I can just make a highlight out of that, and the highlight will never get deleted, right? And the highlight I can actually add it to a compilation, right? To a collection. And the highlight is what you're going to see when all the live streams are going to be deleted in 2 weeks. It's not also going to be left, the highlights. The highlighted moments. So, yeah, I'm doing it that way. The highlights, they walk. On YouTube, I'm uploading the highlights. I'm downloading the highlights and I'm uploading the highlight to YouTube. That's how I do it. There was a golfing class? What is that supposed to mean? A stream, a screen recorder. Well, I can actually show you my setup if you want, because right now nothing's happening, and I think it's, well, it's not really in the context of it. But if I let me move my window. There you go. Wow, magic! It's the backstage. Wow, I know, right? But yeah, it is a lot of stuff to actually keep a track of. But yeah, I'm gonna a golfing class. Yeah, Vasil was all of his depths, and I'm just gonna put this here so you can, so you folks on YouTube and the VOD can see the comments. Vasil was all of his depth and his in-game choices. Yes, indeed. But yeah, you can see the background. Of course, if you wanna see the background, the how I do things, if I'm gaming, you know, while I'm gaming, it is not an official thing, so. If you're popping in, and if I'm not in a battle, then you know I can show you peacefully. Probably they will be watching anyway. Let's be honest. So, yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna call it here, folks. Thanks for joining us today. The Jaeger team definitely lost this one, at least 3-0. Not by much, but it was due to a lack of team management and team cohesion. Meaning the other team was far better than the other. Is that a British expression? Holy hell, I've never heard that, Millwall. But yeah, I'm gonna call it here. Thanks everyone who's been watching. I've been loving having you guys here, and I love being your host. And of course, I will see you guys next time. I hope you will be there too. It really brings joy to me. So yeah, see you next time, guys. Keep yourself updated via the events and on YouTube. Ciao.